Hello and welcome to the Common Dove. Today we have with us Praneeta, who is the founder of Period Society Siliguri. It is a student-led initiative which works towards combating the menstrual taboo via awareness programs and pad distribution drives. She worked in Period Society Jalpaiguri for quite a few time and then came up with the idea of starting Period Society Siliguri. She, along with her team members, have worked efficiently around Siliguri to destigmatize and normalize talks about periods. In this society we are presently living in, it is important to normalize the talks of periods. Can you tell our viewers about the initiatives Period Society Siliguri has taken to do it?
So basically our NGO, as you said, is a student-led initiative. So it's very hard to be honest, it's very hard for students to, because nobody is independent yet. Everybody somehow, you know, putting in their time or some way or the other, they're contributing for the society to work in, to basically for it to go. So we had in Siliguri, since we're a Siliguri base, we had done distribution drive, pad distribution drive in Tikiyapara. We had done a gynecologist, a gyno camp, a gyno free visit gyno in Jalpaiguri. And we had taken few sessions online with different channels, with different, like Padman, Bengal Padman. We had an interactive session with him. So we take online fundraiser events through which there are fun little games through which we create awareness. So that's basically how we work.
Okay, who is Bengal Padman?
Bengal Padman is Mr. Shubham Mukherjee.
Achha, okay. That's really nice, yeah, of you and your team to, you know, destigmatize and totally normalize the talks about periods, because in this society we are living in, it's quite a lot necessary for it. Okay, so moving on. Period Society Siliguri has worked in collaboration with many other period societies, right?
Yeah. We had done collaborate with one chapter so far.
Okay. Can you tell us some more about your collaboration and the exposure you and your team received from it?
Yeah, so basically we had collaborated as in open mic, where people can, you know, artists from different platforms. And we kind of associated different artists, also influencers also, to take part in it, and they were a part of it. So wherein we had taken normal people to take part in it, through which we had fundraised, and all the fundraise has been, you know, used in our camps that we do, our awareness pad distribution drives that we do. So the all money are being used for that, or funds are being used for that. And the exposure, I would say, to be really honest, we are now not that big of an organization.
Yeah,
so the kind of exposure that we get is not really huge.
Okay. But
with the kind of follower that we have, with the kind of
okay, that's really great. The idea of Period Society Siliguri is to destigmatize the talks on periods, right?
Yeah.
So could you tell us more about how a woman on her part should go forward with it?
So I would like to first break this thing into two parts. First of all, the scenario is rural and urban women.
Yeah.
The urban women's situation is very different from the rural women's situation. You exactly. See, education areas are being provided, yeah, but education in rural areas are not being provided. So according to the education that I would say, according to that basis, my suggestion would be that educate yourself, even if you are a menstruator, even if you menstruate. Because first of all, not many people know that women are not the word that is limited to periods.
Yeah.
There are the word used for a period, when we use the word periods, we don't think of only women as an organization. We think menstruated, because in this whole sexual orientation, in the whole spectrum of sexual orientation, there are non-binary people, and then there are trans men who identify as menstruated too.
Yeah.
So, you know, these are the things they come to know only when education is provided to them, when they're accessible to the education. Right. So urban women, in that sense, first of all, educate yourself, educate that how many women in India, how many menstruated in India are actually being able to access pads, and how we can uplift that small number. And to be really honest, when we have worked with women, In urban areas, the women are quite outspoken. They do talk about periods. The number is, of course, not in a huge quantity. It's in a lesser ratio, but then they do talk. Yeah. Whereas in rural areas, it's not at all. So in that case, I would just say that as a woman, if I understand the value that today something might go wrong in my body, today something for which I am on this earth, for which the universe exists, that shouldn't be a shameful act. Right?
Not at all.
As an individual, I need to understand that. So that is how I would suggest the women to go forward to destigmatize this whole taboo.
Serious thing. Yeah, you're totally right. You know, even if the education is available in the rural area, people don't pay much attention to it because they think that it's not necessary for their children to be educated, especially women in our country.
Yeah, right. I mean that is a product of patriarchy, I would say.
Totally.
Yeah, we women in rural areas have been so brainwashed that think like your life revolves around marriage, think like your life revolves around, and you know that's a product of patriarchy, because of which women also, they don't think about anything big other than just marrying big in their life or rich in their life.
Yeah.
So that's another topic though. Yeah,
that's totally a different topic. You are actually right. This is a product of patriarchy, and to deroot this patriarchy, it was going to be a very long process, and it is happening in the rural in the urban area, as we can see. But in the rural area, it is going to take quite a very long time for people to understand the need to educate their children, especially women. Yeah.
Yes.
So, Siliguri is not that big a city, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you Siliguri
is a metropolitan town, town city, you can call that.
Yeah. When you started this idea of starting something based on periods and women, what kind of response did you receive from people? Like, I also saw on the page that there was this girl who was holding a banner or a postcard of like normal, like pick up a rose if you feel that it's normal to talk about people. So like, what kind of response did you receive from people around Siliguri?
So first of all, I would say, like, when we started the organization, since our organization is in Instagram, we are more like active right now. And we got a really good response in the very first day, like from people, from the youth basically.
Yeah.
But then when like take it on road, let's do it physically. Let's go and check people's reaction, people who are not our age, because we at our table can talk about everything. The youth at our table can talk about everything. Yes. When it comes to people who are more than 40 or 35, you know, it's difficult to have a conversation with them because they have a different perspective. Yeah. They have lived a different, have been brought in a different way than we were. So when we tour on road, I still remember this thing because it touched my heart so badly. There was a 65-year-old man who came and picked a rose, and he was like, "You are doing an amazing job." And there were women who were like, "We just have to pick the flower, right?" I was like, "Yeah, you have to just pick the flower. Like, this is so good." And then I was also taking their interviews. So I asked a woman that, "Why do you think that we should talk about it?" Then she, like, why shouldn't we talk about it?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, what there to not talk about it? Why shouldn't we talk? Like, I mean, any part of your body, you bleed, people makes it a huge issue. But you bleed from there for a good cause, and it's like a shameful act. Why? She was like that. And I was like, oh my God, this is a really overwhelming like response that we got. And that was, to be honest, that project was a thumbs up. So yeah, we really got good responses.
Yeah. When are you
and
coming?
We had also had a marathon.
Yeah. I got to know through your Instagram. I got to know about that periods marathon thing. And
we had like 3 to 4 days, I guess, only for the thing, because everything was happening fast. Because of COVID situation, we couldn't delay it. And because of election, we couldn't delay it. So we got permission 3 days before the marathon. We were not sure of anything. So we didn't do anything. So three days before our 4 days, we put that template. And the response that we got, the people that came that morning at 6 a.m. and they participated, like, for us, for a small chapter organization like us, who just recently opened their organization in January, it's a huge thing. So I would say the response is really good.
It also motivates you and your team to work even harder towards this cause, right?
Definitely. Trust me, when like I was holding the mic and I was shouting that, you know, let's normalize period talk, and they were shouting along with me, it was like a goosebump moment. And when guys were coming up, same blood that flows in our veins from our mother, from our sister, we were like, oh my God, that's an overwhelming experience.
It's kind of changing the mindset of the people in Siliguri, because I have lived in Siliguri for a very long time, and I personally realized that it's very necessary, you know, to normalize this talk.
For a developing city as Siliguri, you know,
yes.
I thought that, you know, since it's developing right now, why don't we talk about such a topic? And when I was already already associated with Period Society, I was like, why not open in Siliguri?
Yes.
So that's
and you have worked with the Period Society Jalpaiguri, and Jalpaiguri is also not that big a town, right? Like, it's not so huge.
I initiated the chapter with a friend of mine. Basically, I was co-heading there. So that is also one thing.
I really appreciate your idea of starting something in a very developing city like Siliguri, because people really need to know about this whole thing of normalizing, and it's okay to talk about periods.
Exactly. And the only thing that's regarding period that people don't know, it just so many things, so many aspects, so many problems that women need to know about their body.
Yes,
basically.
Exactly. And, you know, we even have to put this thing up that it is okay, it is normal. It happens with all the women in the country, in the world.
I mean, if not for anybody else, do it for yourself. Know it for yourself. Know it for your own betterment.
Yeah.
You know, in urban areas, sitting in our chair, sitting in our room, sitting in the higher position, we can say that, oh, okay, fine, we know about periods. Why do we talk about so much, right? But then a lot of people don't understand that, because we got that kind of response from people at times, because they were like, why would you hype about it? Why would you talk about it? It's normal. If it's so normal, don't talk about it. It's fine. But when you go to the village area,
So I'm sure our viewers got a great insight to how Period Society Siliguri works and what has it done in so many years. So one last thing I would like to ask you, is there many organizations which work on the cause of periods? How your organization stand out from all of them? like there are many organizations who work towards the this cause and this taboo which still persists in our society.
I would say that our, if you're working for the same cause, I don't think our society needs to stand out any different, because honestly, it's not a competition that I ever want to do with any kind of organization which works for the same cause or which works for any different cause which is for the betterment of the society. It's not a competition. It's rather, you know, breaking the stigma, smashing the stigma together. That's pretty much.
Really great, you know. I'm sure that there will be more people who will understand the cause you're working towards, and especially in and around Siliguri. I wish you all the best for your future endeavors with your team and around, like you work around Siliguri or in any other place, if you wish to start this period society, because you know, due to COVID, it's pretty obvious that you are only stuck towards the arena of Siliguri and, you know, not being able to move out of it. So it's totally understandable.
We had plans in like Bihar. In Katihar, we had to do like an event, but we couldn't do that. In Siliguri only, we cannot do that, let alone be Bihar right now. So and we have everything to talk, but then we cannot do. And you know, the problem is also that, like, It's such a bad situation, no? Because period don't stop for anybody. It doesn't stop for pandemic. And that's our main page ka motive also, that, you know, it does not. So we have initiated a COVID relief fund for menstruator. Let's see how this works and let's see how it goes. Okay. Yeah, pretty much that.
Thank you so much for giving us your time, Pranita. It was really great having you with us.
Thank you so much.
I'll stop the recording.